Hello. My name is Effie.
Oh.
I'm the marketing manager at Novoville. That's fine.
You see the distance.
Okay. Yeah. I'm the marketing manager at Novoville, and I'm here to talk to you about what Novoville is and how we fit into the smart cities paradigm. My colleague George was supposed to be here today with me to share with you his valuable perspective as a software engineer, but unfortunately he's off sick. So if you have any technical questions, please bear with me and I will do my best to answer them. So Novoville is a citizen engagement platform. Now this might sound a bit vague or even romantic, but what it means in simple terms is that we try to facilitate interactions and communication between citizens and local government. Our goal is to transform the public services and influence tomorrow's policies and make them more citizen-centric, transparent, and efficient. So governments around the world, local governments, they need help to improve the services that they offer to citizens without creating additional costs. And when I talk about services, I mean simple things that we all do regularly, like reporting an issue that we come across in our neighborhood, like a pothole on the road or a broken streetlight, paying for a bill or fine, request a service, like garbage collection, or even give our opinion on important matters that concern the area that we live in. All this costs a substantial amount of money, and we have estimated that in the UK, to make a physical visit to the council to request a service, it costs more than £8, and to call the council to request that same service, it costs almost £3. And that's just the cost for the council to receive the request, not the cost to resolve it. And even so, these interactions result in low citizen satisfaction. So the UK public sector has the lowest citizen satisfaction rate than any other sector in the country. People tend to feel excluded from local governance, and that's where we come in. So how do we help them? First of all, let's look at it from a government's perspective. So the Novoville platform has four main features. First of all, we have the electronic front desk, which allows local governments to manage all incoming incidents and requests and reports. They can create dynamic forms, and they can automatically respond to frequently asked questions. Then we have a range of communication tools that allow governments to reach a vast number of citizens instantly using multiple channels like SMS, email, social media, and push notifications. Then we have the payments management system, which allows them to process the payments that are done through the app. From things ranging to from event tickets to council tax bills. And then we have the parking system, which allows citizens to pay for parking time through the app. And the most important thing from the government's perspective is that all these interactions, all these are captured on a central cloud-based dashboard, which gives the council full-time, real-time visibility of everything that's going on in the city. It provides them with useful stats, and it allows them to make informed decisions about how they can improve their services. We also provide citizens with the digital tools that they need to interact with their local government in a more effective way. And we want to move away from the bureaucratic procedures that we've all had to deal with in Greece and other countries for so long. And we want to make this process a more fun experience. So if you use your laptop or your phone to ask a question or request a service, it's easier, it's much more accessible, and it saves time. And at the end of the day, from the government's perspective, it costs a lot less. So you can communicate with your local government using the Novoville mobile app. You can use the web app, which you can find on the municipality's website, or you can use the Novoville chatbot, which we'll get back to in a minute. So what can you do as a citizen with Novoville if you download the Novoville app on your phone? You can do many things. You can report an issue, as I mentioned earlier, that you see in your area, and get instant notifications regarding the progress of your request. You can access the app calendar, where you can find out about events that are happening near you, and get important announcements, like schools will be closed tomorrow due to severe weather, or even emergency alerts. You can voice your opinion by participating in surveys and polls. You can find quick answers without having to search online, like how do I get a marriage certificate, although I doubt most of you will need that yet. You can make payments through the app in the same way as you would buy something on Amazon. You can see points of interest, and you can pay for parking time through the app. I don't know how many of you remember the scratch cards that you have to use to pay for parking. For those of you who don't remember them, it's probably because you were never able to find them anywhere. So I'll focus on just a few of these that people use on a regular basis. I can turn the next, there we go. So if you ask me personally how I would like to be able to report an issue to my local authorities, I would want it to be as simple as finding the location on the map, taking a photo, choosing the category, and then just submitting it with a click of a button. And that's exactly what Novoville does. As soon as you select the issue category, your report is dispatched to the appropriate municipal service or the appropriate employee. And as I mentioned, you get real-time feedback on your report, whether it's in progress or whether it has been resolved. So paying for parking basically follows the same logic as reporting an issue, and it's equally simple. Drivers can purchase parking time for controlled zones around the city using the app, and they get a notification when their time is about to expire, so they can extend it if they choose to. They can also pay for fines. And on the other hand, traffic wardens can do their jobs more efficiently because they can use the custom app to check if the parked vehicles have paid the required amount. Now, there's this myth that making a city smart means that you have to install millions of sensors everywhere and have from like smart buses to smart park benches. But that's not the case. In reality, a city is as smart as its citizens. So what we do is provide an interface that basically allows people to access the services that they are offered. And we train them in a way to use digital tools in order to improve their everyday lives. And the same applies for government employees. Common perception is that they are reluctant to change the way they've always done things, and that they are reluctant to use innovative tools. But from our experience, they're quite open to that. As soon as they realize the positive effect that these tools have on their job. I'll share with you just a couple of examples of our collaboration with local governments in Greece and the UK. So the city of Athens is the biggest municipality in Greece, and they started using Novoville last October throughout a pilot phase at first. The official announcement of our collaboration was done just a few weeks ago. And what I wanted to share with you is the results of these 5 months of pilot operation, which I think are quite impressive. So during these 5 months, they significantly improved communication with citizens. They sent out 11,000 messages that were either about important announcements or feedback on citizens' requests. They were able to increase efficiency by a quarter, mainly due to automated workflows. They reduced call center volume, which is a huge cost burden, because now they're able to communicate with citizens through the platform and vice versa. They resolved a total of 22,500 citizen requests, and they managed to save resources, both financial and human. They used less paper, which is always a good thing, and they saved a total of 720 man hours. Another example is our collaboration with the states of Guernsey, which is one of the Channel Islands in Britain. So they wanted to get people's perspectives on road safety. And we created chatbot consultations, which were accessible to people on Facebook and the council's website. And they managed, so that consultation ran for 4 weeks. And within 4 weeks, they managed to get 1,300 citizen responses, which is 200% higher than using traditional consultation methods at a fraction of the cost. So that had a huge impact in engagement and re-engagement, and that's what we need. We need people to participate more and more so they can influence future decisions. What's more important is that the states of Guernsey use the feedback they got from citizens to implement changes on the infrastructure and road safety policies on the island, such as speed limits. The West Midlands Combined Authority, they wanted to raise awareness on important issues like homelessness and mental health at work. So they used a chatbot consultation, an interactive conversation between them and citizens on Facebook, which lasted for 3 months, and they were able to reach 250,000 citizens. It's always nice to be awarded. So for our collaboration with West Midlands, we won the Urban Challenge Award, and we were shortlisted for the National Democracy Awards in the UK. And last November, during the biggest annual summit for government technology sector, which was held in Paris, we were recognized as one of the top 10 GovTech startups in Europe, which was a huge honor for us, but it also shows how a small idea can go a long way if you're dedicated and if you work hard on it. Last but not least, just a brief Novoville history, because it's always good to remember where we came from. Novoville was founded by Rakhlis Bourabdas and Fotis Talatzis, And the idea behind it, the idea came from a broken garbage bin that they were seeing every day on their way to work. And they found it very frustrating how difficult it was to report it to the local authorities and how long it took for someone to do something about it. So they founded Novoville in 2016, and we now have offices in Greece and the UK. All our engineers are based in Athens, and we have a business development team in London. We have two funding rounds, and at the moment we have 150,000 users in 45 cities in Greece, the UK, Switzerland, and Belgium. This is a few of the local governments that we work with at the moment. Some of them are bigger, some of them are smaller, but the goal is to collaborate with as many local governments in the world as possible to have the greatest possible impact. Please reach out if you found that interesting, and we're always happy to discuss fresh ideas. These are the contact details, and if you have any questions, we'll be happy to answer them during the break. Thank you very much.